What do you mean by that is it's just a term of use. There's never a process where people accept the terms of use.
I have a dream, that's all I need. I'll make it happen with some work and belief.
Terms of condition of website. Let's talk about this. Thing is, when you have a website, it's better to have a terms of condition, especially when you are selling things on your website. Sometimes you just have a website, but you're not selling anything on it. Do you still need a term of condition? I would say yes. Why? Let me tell you why. When someone is using your website, you need to inform the people how they should use the website, what's allowed and what isn't allowed, and all those things you can put in the terms of condition. But if you have a store, that's a different story. You need a different terms of condition for your store. Think about if you are selling things, products or services online, you need a terms of condition for that. And when people pay and how that works. We're not going to talk about that in this video. What we're going to talk about is the terms of use. There's a lot of different way how the people call this, but just call it terms of use. Doesn't matter how you call it. You can call it terms of service, terms of use, doesn't matter. But in this case, we're going to call it terms of use. Okay, you're asking yourself, what are terms of use? Think about it. These are, hey, when you come on a website, you need to use the website like this. The thing is, you give them information about your company and other things about the website. It's a tempo. You can put all those things in the terms of use. Why do you need it? Sometimes when you are online and you have a website, you can tell people, hey, if you visit my website, you're allowed to use this and this for free, and you're not allowed to use my copyright text or photos on the website. You just inform them how they should use your website. It's that simple. Let me be honest with you. Do you need terms of use? If you have a simple website, yeah, just tell people, hey, if you're on a website, you need to use it like this. You're not allowed to do it for this, this, and that. You just inform people about all the stuff. If you have a complicated website, like a store, it's better to have a term of service and how they can order things. Or if you have a membership website, how this works. But all those things has to do with selling products or services online. This is just a simple website, terms of use, how they use the website. How do you implement it? You just make the website, and on the website you put on the bottom terms of use, how they use it, and in the terms of use you can inform the people when they go to your website. The problem with this is it's just terms of use. What do I mean by that is it's just a term of use. There's never a process where people accept the terms of use. Let me go to the whiteboard, and on the whiteboard I'm going to explain to you what I mean. So you see, this is the whiteboard, and I'm going to explain to you what I mean. So imagine this is your website, and you create the terms of use. You put it down here. Let's say X come to your website and visit your website and go away. So X go away. Let's say another person came to your website, and that person copy some things on your website of information and use that information somewhere else. You cannot prove that, sometimes difficult, but just for this example. Thing is, there's nothing wrong with X. Nay, the person doesn't know what how he should use the website. And that's why it's important to put here in your terms how people can use the website. And you put the terms here. You can put it on the website. When people see that, they'll be like, oh, okay, this is how you use it. You can skip people like this. If you copy some content on my website, I will sue you. You can put all those things in the terms of use. You're saying, hey, you're not allowed to copy these things without my permission. You need to contact me on this and this information. So this is how you use terms of use. Thing is, it's not really necessary, but I would advise you to do it. So you can make sure that if someone uses it without your permission, you'll be like, hey, I put it in the terms. It was clear how you can contact me or not. Sometimes people find it difficult to contact the owners, or sometimes they cannot contact the owners. You can put all those things in the terms of use so people know how to contact you and ask you when they are trying to use something from you or not. It's that simple. But if you have a store and you're selling things, or if you have a membership website and you're selling things, it's important to have a terms of services. But it has nothing to do with the terms of use. Terms of use are just saying how you can use the website. That's about it for terms of use. If you have questions about terms of use, feel free to contact me. If you're new to the channel, feel free to subscribe, and I will see you in the next video.
I have a dream. That's all I need. I'll
I'll make it happen with some work and belief. Know what I want, so I'll take it on. I've made mistakes, but mistakes make you strong. Let's break it down for a minute. I want the crown, I'm gon' get it. You hear me loud, man, I'm winning. Yeah, Charlie Sheen will be grinning. These ladies know that I'm sinning, and this is just the beginning. I'm closing in the night, getting. There ain't no point in resisting. Living life like a dream. Big, big,